Hello everyone, this is Sudipta from Technical Potpourri and welcome to my new video. In today's video, I'm going to talk about Generative AI. Generative AI is all over the places right now. In this video, I'm going to talk about Einstein for Developers, which is Salesforce solution for Generative AI. It helps improve the productivity of the developers, and currently this feature is in open beta stage. But in this video, I'm going to show you how you can enable this feature and take advantage of it. So without any further delay, let's jump in and see it in action. So here I am in a developer org. So the first thing that I need to do, I need to go to my setup section and in the search window, search for Einstein for developer. And you'll get this option, click on that, and then you need to enable that option. It will be disabled for you at the beginning, but just, you know, you need to enable that. So once you enable Einstein for Developers, you need to go into your Visual Studio Code. And in the Visual Studio Code, you need to set up your project. So in this video, I'm not going into those details because that's not the intention of this video. But let's assume that you have downloaded the project, you have set up your Visual Studio Code and everything. The first thing that you need to do, you need to go to the extension and search for Einstein for Developers. And you will find this option. Einstein for Developers is basically an extension directly from Salesforce.com. You go and enable that option. Once you enable that option, you will find that Einstein logo on the left panel. So clicking on that, it will basically open this prompt. Here is your place where you will put command or you'll put your prompt and then ask for help. And Salesforce Einstein will give you help and recommendation which you can use for your project. So setup is done. Let's play with this Einstein for Developers a little bit. Here I have a couple of prompts which I want to use, and I want to use in Einstein sidebar and see how it works. So the first thing that I want to do, I want to give a command that I want to create an Apex class. Let's call this account finder. Create a method named getAccounts that retrieves all the child accounts associated with the parent account. The method should accept parent account ID as the parameter, follow security best practices, and ensure the code runs in the user mode. So that's my prompt. And the moment I click on ask, Einstein for Developers will go and find out that this is the solution. This is the code that will do my job. So I asked Einstein for Developers to create a class called Account Finder. So there is Account Finder. Then I asked inside that class, there should be a method called getAccounts. So I can see a getAccounts. And getAccounts is basically taking parameter as parent account as the ID. As the parameter, so I can see parent account ID as a parameter, and then it's actually fetching all the child accounts under that. So what you can do, you can basically, if you think this code is good, this is what you are looking for, you can just copy the code and then you can create your own Apex class and just copy the code there. Or if you think, no, this is not the code that I'm looking for, you can click on ask again, which will give you another recommendation. For example, this is, it looks like it's almost the same. So let's play a little bit more. I have another prompt. So let's clear that. Now, let's say I want to create a logger helper class. And the name of the class I want to give as log helper, which should have overloaded static methods to display error messages coming from DML statements. So let's click on ask and let's see what it gives. It's taking time, and you can see the log helper is the name of the class, and these are all the methods. So there are overloaded methods, log DML exception, log DML exceptions, but these are overloaded method, and these are basically doing my job. But what I can see here, let me copy the code and create an Apex class log helper. And let's put it here. What I can see that it's not able to finish the entire method. It's ended abruptly at the middle. Let me click on ask again and see if it generates the full class again. Seems no. It's not generating the full class. So that's a disadvantage, or maybe that's something that you need to keep your eyes open. Okay, let's clear that. Let's see one more example. This time I want to create a lead converts and custom Apex class, which will be called from the Salesforce flow to convert leads into accounts, contacts, and opportunities. So let's go and click on ask. And again, the same thing. It will be called from Salesforce flow. So I can see that invocable method. That is good. But it's the same problem. The class is not finished. It's ended abruptly. Let's ask one more time and see. It's the same problem. It's not finishing the class. Okay. Let's change a little bit. Instead of calling from Salesforce flow, let the same class will be called from a Salesforce lead trigger. Let's click on ask. Let's see. Not actually looking very promising. The reason is that I can see this time I'm not telling that it will be called from a Salesforce flow. So invocable method is not there, which is good. But if you see this code base, right? If you see this code base and if I copy and put it somewhere here, there's no logic. It's just a definition of the class. And then some variable declaration and all this thing, but where is the actual class? I don't see the actual class which I'm looking for. So I am not very happy. And this is something that we as a developer, we should do. If we feel like it's not what we are looking for, click on this button. Let's click on ask one more time and see if this time it generates some good code. Yeah, this time it looks good. So if I copy the code and put it here, it looks to me it's a lead conversion and it will call from the trigger, which is okay. And then it's calling a lead conversion handler, but where is the lead conversion handler? Because it looks to me this lead conversion handler, the convert lead, this is actually doing the job which I'm looking for. So let's see if it able to understand the context. So what about if I say, can you please write the code for this method? Let's see. It looks like convert leads and all this thing, but it's okay. It's not, and again, it's not finished. It's in the middle. Yeah, but that's what it is right now. I understand that it's in an open beta stage, but when I am playing with this feature, I am not very happy. I'm not very convinced that this feature is going to help me a lot. I don't know about you guys, but let me know. What do you think? What is your experience with this new feature? Put your comment in the description of this video. And I'll keep on exploring this new feature. And if I see there is something which is really cool, I'll definitely bring this in my YouTube channel as a new video. Yeah, but till then, if you think this video is helpful, please hit the like icon, share, and please subscribe to my channel so that you came to know about all my upcoming videos. Till then, thank you. Bye-bye.